Hey guys, I'm kimdao, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I am doing another video where I'm answering your questions that you send to me. So if you guys are new to my channel, I have an email address where you guys just send me questions about anything at all. So in today's video, I'm going to be talking about how safe is Japan. So a few of my viewers sent me questions saying that they are going to Japan soon and they just wanted to know in general how safe Japan really is. So I've been to Japan quite a few times and in general, I can say that Japan is quite a safe country, but there are still things that you have to be careful about. I think when you are traveling, especially if you are traveling alone, you just need to learn how to be a smart traveler. So you need to be aware of your surroundings and know what you are kind of getting yourself into. Whenever I go to Japan, I am comfortable walking around the streets alone in Japan. Obviously, when it's dark, I would rather not, because obviously it's not as safe. Not just in Japan, but anywhere around the world. If it's dark, I usually would avoid walking around in the dark alone. But even if I'm traveling alone at night, I just stay in like really crowded areas. It's Japan, there's so many crowded areas that you can go to. And if I'm in a crowded area, I generally do feel safe there. A few people have asked me about groping on trains in Japan. So in Japan, you might hear a lot of stories about, you know, guys groping girls on the trains. And apparently it's quite common, but I'm gonna be honest, I've never seen it happen myself and it's never happened to me before in Japan. I told my Japanese friends and they told me that I was actually really lucky. My friend who's Japanese said that yeah, it happens to her twice a week at least when she was in high school, like guys would just put their hands up her skirt or something like that. And yeah, we start groping her and she couldn't really do much about it. I think it's just like the Japanese thinking, like they just don't want to cause a scene, they don't want attention put on them, that's why they don't do anything. Obviously, like, you know, I was brought up in Australia, I think a bit differently. If it was me, I probably would have yelled or slapped him, something like that. But yeah, she told me a story. There was one time, there was a guy who was with his girlfriend and they were like standing on a train holding hands and all. And then she said that she felt something. Apparently he actually put his hand down her skirt while he was still holding his girlfriend's hand on the train. And I thought that was ridiculous. And also in Japan now, they've recently started bringing in like women-only carts. So I think it's after hours, like after 6 o'clock or something like that, they have train cars and they are specifically only for women. So that's just to stop all this groping and stuff going on at night time. But like I said, I've never seen it happen myself, but apparently it is a problem in Japan still. If you are a foreigner, I don't think you will have a problem with that in Japan. When I go to Japan, like I do wear skirts that are quite short, but I always wear skirts that have shorts inside them. So if you go shopping in Japan, you'll realize that a lot of stores, they sell skirts with shorts inside them. So I think it's just to protect yourself. And apparently some places in Japan, when you go upstairs, there'll be guys taking photos, like upskirt photos. If you go to train stations like Akihabara, there'll be signs saying beware of upskirt photos. That you can't really help because you don't really know when people are taking photos of you, but if you just wear skirts with shorts underneath, then that's fine. But again, I've been to Japan quite a few times and that's never happened to me before, or I think it's never happened to me before. So I think that area you should be fine. While I'm on the topic of safety in Japan, there was one incident I had that was actually really scary. So what happened was that I was in Tokyo with my friend. We were staying in a hotel in Ikebukuro. So this was probably late at night, maybe at 10 o'clock at night. We were just leaving the train station and just getting out of there to get to our hotel. And I was talking to my friend in English because we're both Australians, we talk in English, even though we're in Japan, it's just much easier to communicate in English. So obviously we were just talking in English and that caught another Japanese guy's attention. I noticed that he looked at me and I looked at him as well and we caught each other's eye. I just kind of ignored it. I was like, oh, that's okay, whatever. Kept on walking, kept on talking. But I realized he was kind of like walking alongside us, which is weird. He was walking alongside us the whole time, for like maybe 100 meters or so. So I turned to my friend and said, can you walk slower? I didn't tell her what was going on, but she walked slower anyway. And I noticed that he started walking slower as well. So he was just matching our pace and walking alongside us. And I thought, this is really strange, like this is not right. So we had to go to the convenience store anyway to buy some water. And I found a police box just outside the station. The convenience store was just across the road, so it was still quite busy around that time. So I thought, okay, let's just go to the convenience store. Let's just buy our water and I'll see if he follows us there. So we were walking, like, you know, he was still walking alongside us and we went to the convenience store and then he entered the convenience store with us and I just knew that he was following. So I bought my water and then I caught his eye again. He was like looking, I don't know, he was just looking around, but I noticed that he was keeping an eye on us too. So he probably thought that we were like stupid foreigners that didn't really know what they were doing. I don't know what his plans were, but what happened was I paid for my water, went outside, and then I looked back at him and he was still around his section, but he was like, I knew he was trying to keep an eye on us. I walked out and then I stood at the police box, and then he walked out and he was looking around, and then he noticed us standing at the police box, and he was just kind of like standing outside the convenience store just playing on his phone. And I don't know what was going on, but eventually after about 2 to 3 minutes he left, because we were kind of like acting like we were gonna go tell the police. So I think he noticed that, and he noticed that I noticed him because I kept looking at him. He did leave in the end, and we waited about 5 to 10 minutes after he left to make sure he wasn't coming back with someone else or something like that. I was gonna actually take a taxi back because there were like taxi bays there, but we didn't feel that it was necessary because the hotel was really close anyway. But anyway, we walked back to our hotel and we were safe. But I think that this sort of thing might happen to anyone in any country, so you just have to be safe and just know what you're doing and just kind of keep an eye on your surroundings, because if I didn't notice him, like, you know, walking alongside us, who knows what would have happened. Also, I find that in Japan, when you walk around alone, or even if you're just with, like, you know, another girl, a lot of guys will come up to you and talk to you, and this is called nampa in Japan, which is kind of like picking up girls. This happens so often and it's so frustrating. I know that it does happen often if they think you are Japanese. If you're Asian, you blend in with the crowd, then they will try and come up and talk to you, try to pick you up pretty much. So usually when that happens, I just say to them in English, sorry, I don't speak Japanese, and they will 99% of the time walk straight away. Sometimes they might try and make conversation with you, but I just pretend I don't understand them and just speak really, really quickly in English. They will pretty much get put off by that and they'll just ignore you. What I find in Japan is that there are a lot of guys trying to pick up girls. So whenever I see a guy trying to pick up a Japanese girl, she just kind of ignores him, just keeps walking. Usually that's what would happen. So I tried that for a bit, but whenever I would just ignore and walk off, they would follow you and just keep trying to talk to you. And I don't know about you guys, but when someone's trying to talk to me and I'm ignoring them, I feel really awkward. And I end up starting to talk to them, which is, I don't know, it's probably bad, but that's just how it is. I just feel awkward if I'm just ignoring someone and they're trying to obviously talk to me. So that didn't really work, but I found what worked for me 99% of the time is just say, sorry, I don't speak Japanese. They will ignore you. Usually if you are a girl traveling with another guy, that usually will never happen. So whenever I travel with my boyfriend, I never have other guys trying to come up to talk to me. There was one incident. I was in Osaka and I was just outside a shopping mall, and my boyfriend and I just crossed the road, but we were just kind of avoiding people because there was a lot of people crossing the road at the same time, and we kind of got separated a little bit. I got to the other end and then a guy came up to me straight away and was like, oh, sashiburi kind of thing. So that just means, oh, it's been a while. And I was just looking at him going, huh? And then he just kind of was like, oh, it's been a while. Like, how have you been? It's me, it's me. And I was like, who are you? My boyfriend kind of caught up with me and just kind of stood next to me, and then he looks at my boyfriend and he's like, oh, okay, I'll see you later, and walks off. So I don't know, maybe that's just like some pickup line that he came up with, which obviously didn't work. But that sort of thing always happens in Japan, even in broad daylight, happens all the time. I also wouldn't really say that they are unsafe, because I usually see them hanging around really crowded areas anyway, so I wouldn't say they're not safe. But obviously, you always have to keep your eye out, you always have to be careful just in case something happens. Also, obviously, like every other country, there are areas that you should avoid. So I know there are some more dangerous areas in Japan that you should avoid. So for example, there's an area near Shinjuku called Kabukicho, and I accidentally walked in there once with my friends, and it's kind of like a red light district. It's really dodgy, there's a lot of like people trying to drag you into their clubs and all, and it's really annoying because they won't leave you alone. Like, they will keep on following you, and then they'll keep on pestering you, trying to bring you into their club. Even though we were with a bunch of guys, they were still trying to get everyone to go to their bars or clubs or whatever. And yeah, it was quite scary. We knew that we weren't in a safe area, so we got out of there straight away. Obviously, that's one area you should avoid. But besides the bad stuff, there are some good stuff. Like, Japan is one of the safer countries to go to, I think. I do feel safer in Japan, to be honest. Like, when I was walking around, this is like my second time in Japan, and I had a lot of cash on me. It was because I like to bring cash to Japan. I don't like bringing cards, because back then, like, using credit cards wasn't really common in Japan, and you wouldn't really find many shops that would accept cards. So I would have like a lot of cash with me. And when I travel, I usually don't carry a lot of cash on me because I don't feel it's safe. So when I'm traveling to like Hong Kong, for example, Vietnam, I never carry a lot of cash on me just in case it gets stolen. So I think Japanese people are quite honest. I lost my camera once. I went to a restaurant and I just accidentally left. I just forgot about it, left it there. And then what happened was, I realized I lost my camera and I knew I must have been in that restaurant. I went back to the restaurant and then they gave it back to me straight away. I had to fill out a form and that was it. Like, I got my camera back. That was just that easy. And there was another time I left my wallet on the counter after paying for some items. It was pretty stupid of me. But yeah, I left my wallet just on the counter, walked off, walked out of the store, went on my way. And the shop assistant actually like chased me down and then gave it back to me. So I got it back. So generally Japan is quite safe. I mean, say for example, if I saw that happen, I would probably chase the person down and hand it back to them as well. But, you know, obviously some other parts of the world, it's not as safe if you leave your stuff lying around. But usually if you leave your stuff lying around Japan or you lose something, usually you can get it back if you remember where you left it. Also, I found that hotels in Japan are really safe. Like, whenever I was in Japan, I never felt that I had to lock up my luggage with all of my stuff in it. Like, when I go to other countries, I would put everything into my luggage and lock up my luggage just in case. But that wasn't the case in Japan. Like, I just kind of leave my stuff lying around, laptop lying around. I didn't feel someone was going to steal it. So I think that, yeah, hotels are generally really safe in Japan. So yeah, that's pretty much all what I have to say, I think. Like, I think Japan is safe. Like, don't worry. The stories that I have told you, it's only happened like once out of like many times I've been to Japan. So it's not something that would happen every day. Obviously, if you're traveling alone, if you're a girl, you have to be careful. You just have to be aware of your surroundings. But yeah, just be careful, pretty much. So yeah, that's it for this video. If you have any more questions about anything at all, send me an email at kimdaoquestions@gmail.com or just leave a comment in the comment box below telling me what other questions you have and I'll make a video about it. It doesn't have to be Japan related, can be about anything. And also follow me on Instagram as well, because I like to post a lot of like my old Japan photos. So if you want to see like more Japan photos or more of my fashion outfits, check out my Instagram. Follow me on my Facebook because I do quite a few updates on there as well. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel if you enjoyed this video for more fun videos about Japan and also some makeup and fashion videos as well. And other than that, thanks for watching and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!